Hello everyone and welcome back to Ritupi's Game Room. Today we are doing an info dump, which is something I haven't done since before the launch of Persona 5, so this will be pretty interesting and fun. If you don't know what an info dump video is on this channel, it's an unscripted video unlike my reviews, where I just go over new information that we got about games and things that interest me, mostly pertaining to Megami Tensei. I stopped doing them after Persona 5 just because there was a lot of complications with Persona 5 videos and everything getting taken down by covering leaked information and everything, so I kind of just backed off from that. But now, seeing that we have official information about SMT5 and Nocturne HD Remaster, I definitely want to go over it, which is what we'll do in this video today. So first things first, let's just start off with Nocturne. Today is a great day as an SMT fan. During Nintendo's Mini Direct today, Nocturne HD and SMT5 got new trailers, which is something I didn't even expect, let alone Nocturne Remastered. It was something that was discussed by Yamai and Team Maniacs in several interviews and surveys of something they'd be interested in doing, but I never thought we'd actually see it now and so soon, close to the release of SMT5. But here are the things that Nocturne HD Remastered includes. It includes higher resolution textures, which is great because if you've ever played Nocturne on an emulator, the models and everything can be upscaled and look really nice, but those textures just look very crunchy and bit pieced and everything like that. It was just not very nice to look at. But seeing that we have clean and smooth textures on these upscaled models is just excellent, and I'm excited to play it and experience it that way. Voice acting is now included in the game, which is an option you can turn on and off for fans who don't want the voice acting and keep the original experience intact, but I am going to play it personally with the voice acting because I feel like the voice acting can elevate it, elevate the experience to another level. The original version had no voice acting, if you didn't know, but games around the same time that came out, like Digital Devil Saga, did have voice acting, and I feel like the atmosphere in that game was elevated ever so slightly thanks to the excellent voice acting done by the actors and everything, and I feel like the voice actors do the voice work for Nocturne will do a really good job. I'm just hoping that they bring back Matt Mercer as Raito Kuzunoha. Speaking of Raito Kuzunoha, it appears that we are getting the Raito version of the game here in America. If you didn't know, the game originally in America had Dante in it, and it was later updated in Japan to have Raito Kuzunoha instead of Dante, and we never got that version here, but now we're finally getting the Raito version. Maybe, unless when they bring it over here to America finally, we'll get Dante, who really knows, but we'll see what happens. Difficulties will include normal and hard mode, with a merciful DLC as an option, which I think is great. Nocturne is known for its difficulty because, well, it's a very difficult and unforgiving game, but I feel like adding that merciful option for fans who just kind of want to experience it and aren't very good at turn-based RPGs, finally enjoy and experience this game, which I think is a good thing. And I mean, if you're upset that, oh, well, that's just going to make it too easy for everyone, you still got your hard mode, you still got your normal mode to go back and play through, which will still be a challenge. There was also a collector's edition announced, which is called the Reality Expanse Box, which will be bundled with a Terminal Nightlight, a copy of Hijiru's occult magazine from the beginning of Nocturne, a piano arranged soundtrack, and a rare song soundtrack, which will probably include music from Nocturne's beta. And that all comes bundled together in a treasure chest box, which is funny because it's very similar to the original PS2 Collector's Edition, which I have, which also included a treasure chest box and a terminal, although the terminal was an incense burner instead of a light. There is an SMT Nocturne Celebration stream on this Thursday, which may include more info on the remaster, and we'll take a look back on the series. I don't know if it will show off any information, but maybe. If it does, I'll probably cover it, but if not, I mean, it's still a neat little thing to have. It is also important to recognize that this is probably a direct result of the Atlas surveys they put out every year, so if you want to see more re-releases and remakes, don't forget to take those surveys. Even if they're just meant for Japanese audiences and stuff, you can still take the surveys. You might just need to use Google Translate or something to get through it, but I think it's very important, and this is proof, along with, you know, Catherine being released on PC and Persona 4 Golden being released on PC, it's proof that they are listening to what fans want, and if you just keep letting them know, they'll probably do it. Also, one small detail that I just love so much is that the box art is the same as the original box art, but now with a new gold iteration. If you don't know, Nocturne in all of its various iterations except one, which had Raito fighting Demi-Fiend on the cover, but beside that one, it was all the same box art. with different colors, you know, the half picture of Demi Fiend's face. The original version that we got was red, but they also had a blue one and a white one in Japan. And now we're finally getting a gold version, and it would be really cool if it was holographic, but it might not be. But as someone who loves holographic covers on their physical games, I'm begging for it. Anyway, Nocturne Remastered will release on October 29th, 2020 in Japan, and release in America in 2021. And that's pretty much all we have on the game so far. So next, let's tune over to SMT5. We're going to be taking a look at the trailer. I'm going to break it down to some different things that caught my attention. I'm not going to read every line of dialogue and everything, but I will cover interesting parts that I feel will be relevant. So in the trailer, we're first greeted with what appears to be Archangels and Dominion in his SMT2 art, which are facing off against Lucifer and his demon horde. During this, Lucifer tells us that Yahweh might be dead in the title, perhaps thanks to the events of SMT Apocalypse or SMT2, or maybe even Deep Strange Journey's new ending with Shekinah, like mentioned in an earlier SMT5 trailer, so maybe they're going with the Shekinah route instead of the Yahweh route. We don't really know for certain. And if you don't know what Shekinah is basically the female presence of God, so it could be interpreted as the female version of God, and there's all these obtuse different observations that do with Shekinah and everything, and I think they'll probably try leaning more towards that. Or, you know, altogether, this could just be a whole new universe, and it wasn't really meant to tie into any of the other games. But I do think that Deep Strange Journey was definitely intended to be a teaser for what was coming in SMT5 with the whole Shekinah thing, because that's a common trend that's tied between both. Anyway, we see our protagonist for the first time, and he has a very gender-neutral appearance that I think is a pretty cool take on a mainline protagonist. Usually they're buff, really dudes, but I think having a more feminine character is pretty neat, and it's kind of similar to how Legend of Zelda does it with Link, where Link has more of a gender-neutral appearance, so, you know, anyone can kind of fit into the mold and not feel left out, which I think is an interesting way to do it. All the background NPCs appear to have no face, much like in Persona 5, but it's a stylistic choice that I think works well here. It's also pretty much confirmed at this point that the artwork is done by Doi in this game instead of Kaneko, sadly, but if you were expecting Kaneko to come back in an art role, you were destined to be disappointed anyway. Kaneko may do a new demon design or something, you never know, but don't hold your breath over it. It also appears that the world has been thrown into chaos, much like Yamai was talking about in interviews, about how there's this whole air of fear about what's to come next, because we don't know what's to come next, you know? This fear of unemployment, nuclear war, all these different things that can really stress people out, and especially with the advent of, you know, a particular virus, which I won't say so I don't get demonetized. All these different factors, I think, will play an important role in SMT5 in one way or another, but we'll just have to see. We see a scene that almost mimics an early trailer where the protagonist is about to be killed by demons, but with the surprising lack of the female character we saw in the previous trailer. But anyway, as he's about to be killed, we see a demon that I think might be Asura. Don't quote me on that, that's entirely a guess, but his design just evokes this feeling like, oh, this kind of looks like Asura to me, personally. It appears that our protagonist makes a pact with Asura, similar to how Nanashi and Dagda formed a pact in Apocalypse. As they form a pact, it appears that the protagonist maybe transforms right before the logo cuts off, because you see him get sucked up in these swirls and stuff that forms from their handshake, and I feel like that's a transformation or something of that nature. Maybe the protagonist will have a demon form a la Surf and Gang from Digital Devil Saga. Maybe he'll be tatted up as a god slayer like Nanashi. It also appears that we might have organic demon summoning in this game, like with Demi Fiend, since there's a lack of comp that we at least can't see on the protagonist's arms. Maybe he'll use a laptop or something like Nakajima from Megami Tensei, but who knows. Also, to support my thing that he might change forms or he might get tatted up, is that we see a wave pattern around the logo on the trailer and the website, and that wave pattern is seen when he shakes hands with that Asura-like demon, so maybe that plays some importance, maybe it's a transformation thing, who knows, this is all just conjecture, this is all just guessing, but if I'm right, that'd be awesome. But Anyway, that's pretty much all the information that we have on SMT5 and Nocturne Remastered. With Nocturne Remastered, I mean, it's a pretty straightforward remaster of the original with some quality of life changes, I'm sure, and some new, with the new voice acting and everything. So I wouldn't look forward to too much being different there. But this is all really exciting. Nocturne's like my favorite game of all time, and I'm excited that we're finally getting the new entry in SMT. So yeah, there it is. If you're curious about what my next video is, I am currently playing through Kyuyaku Megami Tensei, which is the SNES remake of Megami Tensei 1. Once I'm finished with that, I'll record the video, get that out to you guys, and move on to the next game, which is Kyuyaku Megami Tensei 2. But that's getting ahead of myself. Anyway, this has been Ratupi from Ratupi's Game Room, signing out. Peace.